Hugh Morris. As Jeff Jarrett got out of the way, Jeff Jarrett makes the cut.
Well, here comes a standing McMichael.
Mongo, the former All-Pro. Look at that power slam of a 300-plus pound man. And now he's got Konnan up, and he muscled him down. Three-point stance. From the scrimmage line, he took his knee right out. Again. Oh, he is so quick. Out of the three-point stance.
It's Public Enemy.
Public Enemy, they're going for the briefcase. Public Enemy. Remember, they beat this duo last week, and they will face this duo at Uncensored.
Jarrett's yanking.
Oh, my goodness.
Clobbered him.
He knocked him right out.
Wait a minute. That was an accident.
That was an accident. That was an accident.
That was a heck of an accident.
I would hate to be around when McMichael wakes up. Oh, for crying out loud, that was unfortunate. And for Mongo and Jeff Jarrett, they are now 0-2 since Jarrett became a Horseman as a tag team. And they're 0-2 as they go in now to Uncensored.
Well, it is Arn Anderson and Ric Flair. Well, they tried to hold these guys together, and it was working out pretty well until the Public Enemy, but look at right there, snatching that Halliburton away. Caught McMichael's right smack in the fit. Oh, got him in the head and the face.
Oh, boy, you can see his head. He's injured. Steve Mongo McMichael, I'm not so sure if he is out or if he can get to his feet. But nonetheless, winners, Konnan and Hugh Morris of the Dungeon of Doom, and we're ready to go to the ring in Gene Okerlund.
All right, Tony Schiavone, you've just seen a blast come up here. Jeff Jarrett, maybe there's some kind of explanation.
We can
have. What happened?
No, you talk to me, because I'm talking to you. I thought we left this kind of garbage on the West Coast last week.
No.
You're not that clumsy.
No.
You want to explain this one?
Yeah, I got some words to say. Listen, Anderson, don't come out here and start instigating. Because last week, I proved that I was a Horseman. I proved that I was Horseman material. The only reason I was outside the ring was to protect Deborah. Now, Rick knows as good as anybody.
No, ain't Rick.
You know good as anybody. You know as good as anybody. You stood behind me from day one. You said I was the man. No, that was purely an accident, and you know it.
Well, you know what? You're making the Nature Boy look bad, pal.
There's got to be some...
We gave you a chair. Sit in it. Quit falling off it.
There's got to be some semblance of order.
What was that?
Hey,
I thought this was settled.
That was an accident.
I thought this had better been an accident.
That's exactly what it was, Gene. Arn, that's exactly what it was. It was an accident.
Enough of this. I mean, sure, I got my way. I wanted Jeff Jarrett and Four Horsemen.
Wow.
But I tell you know, Rick, tonight it was a mistake. And Arn, it was a mistake tonight. And even Steve, he knows what happened tonight was a mistake. But I tell you, I think we're all just trying too hard. So we've got to pull together, because in 2 weeks, you and Steve have the Public Enemy.
Exactly.
And I am not going to be on a losing team.
Well, I ain't either. Gene, I can promise you, at Uncensored, not only am I going to prove to Public Enemy that they're down here and the Horsemen up here, but I'm going to prove to you two guys that the Four Horsemen are way up here and they're going to stay up here with Jeff Jarrett, a member.
All right, I thank you very much, gentlemen and ladies. There is a difference, Tony and Larry, between what I consider to be a mistake and intentional neglect. What did we see here tonight? Gentlemen, back to you.
All right, Gene, I'm not so sure, but one thing remains. Chris Benoit, we understand, is still in the hospital, and the problems continue to exist within the Horsemen. Coming back, DDP is back with us. Stay with us on TNT.